Guess who's back, 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 back again, again, again. Ginger's back, back, back. Welcome to LCR, Liverpool's finest community radio. Guess who's back, 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 back again. Hello and welcome to LCR. My name's Stephen Webber, all the way from sunny Liverpool, and my co-presenter tonight is Olivia, all the way from Slovakia. Say hello, Olivia.
Hello, everybody.
And how are you tonight?
I'm all right, thanks, Steve.
Right, so our show's about Redhead, or what's it like to be a Redhead. Well, what is it like to be a Redhead? A ginger, a ginge, a carrot top. Well, me personally, I love it. I like the attention it brings. I like to stand out in the crowd. I feel unique. I'm part of a rare breed, which I'm really proud of. Now, let's have a classic song from The Who.
Thank you.
What an absolute classic tune.
Woohoo!
Livia, do you know Redhead's produced their own Fisherman D?
No, I didn't know that.
No, that's how unique we are and how rare we are. Yeah.
I can read here, a friend of me, that only approximately 1 or 2% of humans, or about 2 in 100 people in the world, have red hair.
Again, another rare breed. Mm-hmm. And that's why I'm proud to be a ginger. And the ancient Greeks believed that redheads would turn into vampires after they died. What a cheek. Nice. Just imagine me living in Greek in them time, in them days.
I can imagine that.
I probably would have killed me. Right. Or chewing on all them people's necks.
Steve the sucker.
Looking for blood.
Oh, and this is the good one. Did you know that the woman with the red hair have more sex than the woman with the other hair colours? Did you know that, Steve?
I didn't, you know. It makes you wonder, though, doesn't it? Aye. All them ginger girls out there with a smile on their face.
are very naughty. Very naughty.
And during the witch hunts of the 16th and 17th centuries in Europe, many women were burnt at the stake as witches merely because they had red hair. How sad is that?
That is very sad. No.
It is.
Another one here, redhead woman bruise more easily. So I think I have the, genes of the ginger people, because I bruise very, very easily, unfortunately.
And people with red hair have twice the risk of developing Parkinson's disease. Mm-hmm. So I've got something to look forward to in later life, haven't I?
And Hitler banned the marriage of redheads in order to prevent divine offsprings. That is horrible.
I know. Typical of Hitler. Mm. And the perfect race he was trying to get in them days.
Yeah.
And gingerphobia is a fear of redheads. You'd be scared of redheads. It would be scared.
Well, I'm certainly not scared of you, Steve. Certainly not. Gingerism is the bullying of produce of redheads. And we are going to talk about it later in the show anyway. So, shall we just mention some of the famous redheads?
Yeah, why not? Yeah, because there's quite a few.
But there is, I didn't know that, for example, Cleopatra was redhead. So I'll tell you about it later on. Or Helen of Troy, or Queen Elizabeth I. Have you got anyone?
Yeah, Malcolm X.
Wow.
Yeah, and again, I'll talk about Malcolm X a bit later on. Then we had, Sir Mark Twain, Winston Churchill.
Winston Churchill.
Oliver Cromwell.
That's a good... Galileo.
Galileo, yeah. And the Roman Emperor Nero. And obviously there's people like myself and that, you know, who are famous in these parts of Liverpool.
Everybody knows you, Steve.
Yeah.
Everybody knows
you. We're going to go to a bit of more music, and this is another classic tune from Talking Heads.
I can't sleep 'cause my bed.
classic tune from Talking Heads, Psycho Killer. When we were talking about before, we were saying about famous Redheads, and the person that I like to speak about is Malcolm X. African-American civil rights leader Malcolm X was born Malcolm Little on May the 19th, 1925 in Omaha, Nebraska. He was the fourth of seven children. His father, Reverend Earl Little, was an African-American Baptist minister from Reynolds, Georgia. He was an imposing figure, 6'4" and with one eye. His mother, Louise Little, was born in Grenada in the British West Indies. Her background was very different from her husband's. She was an educated woman with mixed heritage. Her father was white, and so she was light-skinned. She looked like a white woman. Malcolm recalls in his autobiography, she had straight black hair and her accent did not sound like a Negro's. Although Malcolm's father was very dark-skinned, he inherited much of his mother's complexion. His skin was the lightest of all seven children, and as a result, as a child, he believed he was better treated by his father and escaped many of the routine beatings suffered by his siblings. Malcolm X's red hair. Malcolm also inherited a reddish colour in both his skin tone and hair from his white grandfather's side, which later earned him the nickname Detroit Red. The civil rights leader's mother's partial white ancestry was a sore point within the family. She had never met her father and was ashamed of her link to him. Malcolm himself became to resent the genetic legacy that has awarded him his light skin and red hair. I learned to hate every drop of that white racist blood that's in me, he said. Now we're going to play another tune.
I'll get ya!
Welcome back to LCR. My co-presenter, Olivia, is now going to talk about Cleopatra.
Yeah, Cleopatra was supposedly not Egyptian. She was a Macedonian Greek, and her color was described as bronze gold or light red. There are some images of her with red hair as well. Her statue, exhibited at the British Museum in 2001, portrays her as plain, no more than 5 foot tall, and rather plump. She born in Alexandria in 69 BC into a Macedonian Greek dynasty, which had ruled Egypt for three centuries. Cleopatra acceded to the throne at 17. So Cleopatra's mother may have been Egyptian, but she probably also had some Macedonian backgrounds. There are three other matters worthy of consideration. One, what I like the most, is that Cleopatra was the only ruler of her dynasty who knew, in addition to her native Greek, the Egyptian language as well. Did you know this, Steve?
I didn't.
Yeah. So, shall we play another music? And this is going to be Joe Slater. It's a local artist. Enjoy it.
God, if you're dead, tell me why you're scared. Come down your stairs
Welcome back. What an absolutely superb voice that young man's got. A bright future for Joe. There's a common perception that redheads will become extinct in 100 years. However, National Geographic article states that while redheads may decline, barring a catastrophe, the gene for red hair will not likely to become extinct. Do you know that Scotland has the highest proportion of redheads in the world? 13%, followed by Ireland with 10%. The United States has the largest population of redheads in the world, with between 6 and 18 million redheads, or 2 to 6% of the population. And here's a famous clip from Catherine Tate called Ginger Hair Safe House.
Expecting you. Don't worry, you're safe now. Would you like to bring Sandra through?
Through to the other room?
Yes.
Are there more people through there?
Ginger people? Yes, there are. This is a ginger refuge.
I brought Sandra here because we're short staffed, but I can't. It's not the smell. It's just that I'm not qualified to work with ginger people. I'm sorry. We'll get your stuff sent on to you, eh?
Sandra, the police are some of the most gingerphobic people in society. Don't worry. As I said, you're safe now. Come through. Welcome to Russet Lodge. Can we join you, Helen? This is Sandra Kemp. She's just arrived.
Hello.
Hi.
Oh, she's beautiful. Does her mum live at the refuge?
I'm her mum.
I don't understand.
You're not... The ginger gene can skip a generation. Helen is what's known as a carrier. Though carriers can blend into society much more easily than gingers, at some point, communities find out. And people like Helen are driven out of their homes too.
So, I'm just like you. I may not be ginger here, but I'm ginger here.
And welcome back. What a funny clip that was. Now we're going to talk about someone who's really famous, Mick Hucknall. He may have found fame with Simply Red, but you mustn't mention the colour Mick Hucknall's hair. The ginger singer claims making fun of his roots is akin to racism. After facing a series of belittling comments on social network and website Twitter, the 51-year-old told his followers, "Let's play a game. Whenever you read ginger, try replacing it with black or Asian and see how it reads." The pop star questions why a string of prominent Britons were not simply defined by the colour of their hair. Interesting also that Prince Harry almost never referred to a ginger by the media. He noted, "or Churchill, or Elizabeth I, or Shakespeare." And lest we forget, dear old Henry VIII. Now here's a second clip from Catherine Said.
Being ginger is who I am. Why should I deny that? You shouldn't. And that's why we're here. We have all sorts of gingers here. Gingers in denial. confused gingers, even militant gingers. But they have one thing in common. They don't need to fear the outside world. They're all welcome to stay here in peace and harmony.
I've had enough of you! I don't know that last time!
Put the bottle down.
What's she doing here? She's not even ginger! She's strawberry blonde. You have as much right to be here as you. Look at her face. She's not even pale. I'm as ginger as you are. How come you're the only one who uses the garden when it's sunny? Oh, look. She's getting a tan. All right, everyone, that's enough. Look at us. Look at us. From strawberry blondes to flame-haired beauties, we are all ginger. And if we can't get on with each other in here, what chance do we have in the real world? Duracell. Ginger nut. Carrot top. Copper knob. We're used to getting that kind of abuse every day out there. People asking us to move away from areas where food is being prepared. Total strangers assuming we're Scottish. Forever trawling the streets, trying to find a hairdresser's that isn't fully booked. Well, not in here. This is a safe haven for everyone and everything ginger. Let's keep it that way.
I'd like to build and furnish it with love. Grow apple trees and honey bees and snow white turtle doves. I'd like to teach the world to sing.
Welcome back. This is Livia and Steve. We're talking today about ginger and gingerism. We already covered lots of facts, and here is the other one. Approximately 1 in 10 people in the UK has ginger hair, or Tsetian hair as it is sometimes known, giving us one of the highest redheads rates in the world, or gives you, not me.
The colouring is caused by high levels of pigment, phenylalanine, and relatively low ones of the darker emelanine. There are plenty of historical examples of extreme gingerism.
And in 15th century Germany, redheads were seen as witches, and 45,000 were tortured and murdered. Elsewhere, the Egyptian burned ginger people alive, and the Greek claimed they turned into vampires when they died. We already spoke about that before.
Nevertheless, some of the modern world's most desirable women are redheads, including Lily Cole and Karen Olsen.
A redhead family claims to have been driven from their Newcastle home because of abuse. Did you know that?
I didn't. And why is harassment of redheads dismissed as just harmless fun?
Here is a joke. What is the difference between a terrorist and redheads?
I haven't got a clue. What is the difference between a racist and a redhead?
You can negotiate with a terrorist.
That's terrible. Is this offensive? If it was made in your workplace within hearing of a redhead colleague, would you make a fuss?
Well, not me, definitely not me.
But mock someone's ethnicity, religion or sexuality and you will attract the BDI of management. Make a sexist joke and prepare to be dismissed as an anti-deviant relic. Right, is another classic song from Big Audio Dynamite.
Somebody I never met, but in a way I know, didn't from the picture show. Man dies first, real people ask, what's the deal? This ain't how it's supposed to be. Don't like no aboriginal. Took a trip in Power Square. Pop star died as hell. No fans are screaming, shouting. Monsters came to flush him out. Gangland's laying underground. New identity must be found. On the left hand for a while. Insanity, bohemian style. Dressed like Little Red Riding Hood. Bad habit, taking life. A calling card, a six-inch knife. Ran off, Billy Foss. Mumbled something about the past. Best sex I've ever seen. As if each moment was a loss. Drops of blood, color side. Funeral for his bride. But it's him who's really dead. Guess to take the funeral ride. Scratch my head and wonder why. Time slides into time across an actual dateline. Scientist eats bubblegum. Hall of Fame baseball. Senators a hoodlum. Big Chiefs in a hall.
Guess who's back, 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 back again, again, again. Ginger's back, back, back. Welcome to LCR, Liverpool's finest community radio.
Guess who's back, 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 back again.
Yeah, yeah. Say he's back. Oh, hi, welcome back. This is Livia and Steve speaking, talking about gingers today and gingerism. As Steve said before, I am originally from Slovakia, so me as a Slavic person, I must say that my observation is that redheads are more rare in Slavic population than in Germanic and especially Celtic ones, but still visible. Me personally, I have no redheads in my family, but I have friends who is blonde and her husband is dark hair with dark eyes, and they have three kids and all three are literally pure redheads. And they have no redheads in the family. So that is quite rare and quite funny as well for us to see. A higher rate of red hair from the Slavic point of view are in Belarus, Poland and Ukraine. And it could be the result of migration from Scotland and the Holy Roman Empire in the history. Otherwise, it's quite rare, to be honest with you, in our region. So, shall we have another piece of good music now? And then we can tell you some serious stuff about some abuse of redheads. Go on, then, Steve, put something on.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again, because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping. And the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence. Restless dreams I walked alone, narrow streets of cobblestone, neath the halo of a street lamp. I turned my collar to the cold and damp, when my eyes were stared by the flash of a neon light to split the night and touch the sound. Silent, and in the naked light I saw 10,000 people, maybe more. People talking without speaking, people hearing without listening, people writing songs that voices never share. Said I, you do not know. Silence like a cancer grows. Hear my words that I might teach you. Take my arms that I might reach you. But my words, like silent raindrops, fell. Echo. Out its warning in the words that it was forming, and the sign said the words of the prophets are written on the subway walls, tenement halls, whispered the sounds of silence.
And welcome back. Now we're going to finish the show with some interesting quotes and stuff on verbal abuse, like carrot top, copper top, ginger nut, ginger minger, bluey, among Australians, Duracell, Ronald McDonald, Simply Red, Queen Elizabeth, and so on for hours and hours of a typical redhead's life. No wonder some people gloss over their hair colour as auburn, strawberry blonde, or Asian, or even Titian gold. Michelle Elliott, American director of British children's charity Kidscape, regularly has sufficient numbers of red-haired children in courses on coping with bullying. She quotes, "There is nothing like this in the US, where having red hair is not a precursor to having someone abuse you. Red hair is considered glamorous. Bullies at school and in later life may sense that ill-treaters of red hair will not be treated as seriously by the authorities as persecution of other groups. Bullies think that a person is outside the norm, they will be able to attack them. The bullies find something to pick on. The bully has a problem and needs a victim, says Mrs. Elliot. Right, now for another tune. Coming to the end of our show today about red hair and gingerism. So my name's Stephen Webber and my co-presenter's Olivia, and I think she's going to have the final word.
Yeah, I would like to recommend you a book from Charlotte Rushton, which is called Ginger Snap, and she was herself redhead, so please read it. It's through. I'm not going to tell you what is it about. And the last, what I want to say, that we should pity those who think they have all the rights to try to bully redheads, because they will more than likely be bullied before them. So, and on this bombshell, I would like to say thank you to Steve and everybody you listening to LCR Radio, and we have one more last song for you. Thanks. Bye.
Bye now.
This is a song about prejudice and the language of prejudice and the power of the language of prejudice. It's called Prejudice.
Prejudice.
Prejudice. In our modern free-spoken society, there is a word that we still hold taboo. A word with a terrible history of being used to abuse, oppress and subdue. Just six seemingly harmless letters arranged in a way that will form a word with more power than the pieces of metal that are forged to make swords. A couple of G's, an R and an E, an I and an N. Just six little letters, all jumbled together, have caused damage that we may never mend. And it's important that we all respect that if these people should happen to choose to reclaim the word as their own, it doesn't mean the rest of you have a right to its use. So never underestimate the power that language imparts. Sticks and stones may break your bones, but words can break hearts. A couple of G's, cheese, unless you've had to live it. An R and an E, even I am careful with it. An I and an N, in the end it will only offend. Don't wanna have to spell it out again. Yeah. Only a ginger can call another ginger ginger. Only a ginger can call another ginger ginger. So listen to me, if you care for your health, you won't call me ginger unless you ginger yourself. Yeah, only a ginger can call another ginger ginger. Ginger life is pretty hard. Years of ritual bullying in the schoolyard. Kids calling your anger and fan of pants. No invitation to the high school dance. But you get up and learn to hold your head up. You try to keep your cool and not get head up. But until the feeling of ill is truly let up, then the word is ours and ours alone. Don't you know that only a ginger can call another ginger ginger? Yep, only a ginger can call another ginger ginger. So if you call us ginger, we just might come unhinged. If you don't have a fringe with at least a tinge of the ginger in it, only a ginger can call another ginger ginger. Now listen to me, we're not looking for sympathy just because we're sensitive to UV. Just because we're pathetically pale, we do all right with the females. Yeah, I like to ask the ladies round for ginger beer, and soon they're running their fingers through my ginger beard and dunking my ginger nuts into their ginger tea. Yeah, and asking can they call me ginger, and I say I don't think that's appropriate, because only a ginger can call another ginger ginger. Yeah, and all the ladies, they agree it's a fact, once you're gone ginger, she can't go back. Only a ginger can call another ginger ginger. Yeah, go ginger, go, you funky motherfucker.
back and tin. Yeah, you can call us Bozo or Fire Truck. You can even call us Carrot Top or Bladnut. Yeah, you can call us Matchstick or Tampon. But fucking with the G word is just not on. If you're a gingerphobe and you don't like us, we will stand up to the fight if you want to fight us. But if you cut yourself, you might catch gingivitis. So maybe you should shut your funky mouth. Yeah, only a ginger can call another ginger ginger. Yeah, only a ginger can call another ginger ginger. So if you call a ginger, you can't whinge. If you're injured, if you don't have a tinge of the ginger in your minge, only a ginger can call another ginger ginger. You know my kids will always be clothed and fed, 'cause Papa's gonna be bringing home the gingerbread. And they'll be pretty smart because they'll be well read. And by red I mean red, and the other kind of red, it's a homophone. And only a ginger can call an eye ginger ginger. Yeah, only a ginger can call another ginger ginger. Just like only a ninja can sneak up on another ninja. Only a ginger, only a ginger, only a ginger, yeah. Are you listening? I'm not pointing the finger, I'm just having a singer. I am just reminding ya that only a ginger can call another ginger, ginger.